Get ready for an absolute blast in 2024. SpaceX is going to ace third orbital launch of Starship Super Heavy. Yes, you heard it right. Stay tuned in, I will explain. In response to valuable feedback from our community members in our recent episode, I have decided to discontinue featuring this avatar in our videos. Your suggestions are highly appreciated, and I genuinely value your opinions. Thank you all for being awesome contributors to our community. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. Kathy Lueders, serving in her role as the general manager of Starbase, recently delivered an expansive presentation that illuminated the intricacies of the initial two orbital test flights and delineated the prospective trajectory for the burgeoning spaceport. The preceding year witnessed Elon Musk, the CEO of SpaceX, sparking contemplative discussions among local supporters by positing the idea that Starbase could metamorphose into the company's preeminent hub for advanced research and development. This visionary perspective envisioned Cape Canaveral assuming the mantle of the primary operational launch site for the ambitious Starship. However, the realization of this potential transition was predicated on a pivotal decision: the approval of SpaceX's launch license for an orbital flight test from Starbase by the Federal Aviation Administration, FAA. This significant juncture ultimately materialized with the issuance of the green light for two pivotal flights, the first on April 20th and the subsequent on November 18th. Lueders, in the course of her presentation, undertook a profound exploration into the intricate details of the second orbital test flight. A salient and noteworthy facet was the strategic utilization of data gleaned from the April 20th flight, an event that concluded with a self-destructive incident subsequent to a stage separation failure. The assimilation of this invaluable information proved instrumental in the meticulous refinement of the Starship Super Heavy configuration that would be employed in the subsequent flight. This strategic approach not only showcased SpaceX's unwavering commitment to continual enhancement, but also underscored the organization's commitment to learning from the complexities and nuances of previous missions. The November 18th flight, culminating in the booster and Starship undergoing self-destructive procedures after a successful hot stage separation, unfolded with a rich tapestry of possibilities and implications. The initiation of the flip maneuver, a nuanced and intricate aspect of the flight, hinted at the booster's inherent capacity to deactivate outer engines while adeptly maintaining operational functionality in the center. The challenges encountered during the boost-back burn phase for Booster 9, albeit momentarily perturbing, were met with an exemplary demonstration of resilience from the SpaceX team. The successful reignition of most center engines following an otherwise flawless hot staging event showcased not only technical prowess, but also the organization's capacity to troubleshoot and overcome challenges. Despite some notable engine failures during the flip maneuver, Lueders sought to highlight the silver lining, the lessons derived from these experiences, further enriching SpaceX's reservoir of knowledge and expertise. In addressing a substantive concern, Lueders delved into the ongoing anomaly investigation, an intricate process aimed at discerning the reasons behind the activation of the automated flight termination systems during the November 18th flight. With the positive outcome of stage separation, subsequent flights are poised to concentrate on validating various components of the system. This meticulous approach to anomaly investigation not only underscores SpaceX's commitment to safety and precision, but also reflects a commitment to transparency and understanding and rectifying challenges that may emerge during the exploration of uncharted territories. The setbacks encountered, as articulated by Lueders, are not roadblocks, but rather stepping stones toward greater understanding and refinement of space travel technologies. Amidst the challenges and setbacks, Lueders sought to convey an aura of excitement and optimism. The developments at SpaceX, particularly at Starbase, were characterized as transformative, marking a significant inflection point in the company's trajectory. Starbase, she asserted, is not merely a launch site. it is evolving into a dynamic and integral component of SpaceX's operational landscape. The resonance of her words conveyed a palpable sense of the paradigm shift underway, with Starbase emerging as a linchpin that is poised to redefine the contours of space exploration and technological innovation. Her vivid recollection of witnessing the November 18th launch from a close vantage point served as a poignant testament to the monumental nature of these endeavors. The visceral experience, characterized by the shaking of buildings and rattling of windows dozens of miles away, painted a vivid picture of the sheer power and magnitude of SpaceX's undertakings. This shared experience, bridging the gap between the scientific intricacies of space exploration and the lived experiences of local residents, served to foster a sense of communal engagement and appreciation for the collective journey into the cosmos. Lueders, with unwavering conviction, underscored the pivotal role of Starship in NASA's Artemis program for human moon landings. The next year, she articulated, is poised to be critical, signaling a phase of intensive testing to propel Starship into its next level of operational capability. The goals outlined are ambitious yet tethered to pragmatic considerations, encompassing the testing of Starship's capabilities, achieving booster reusability, and refining landing operations. The commitment to bringing back the big booster, turning it around, and launching again represents not just a technical milestone, but a testament to the vision of sustainable and cost-effective space travel. The narrative extends to Starship itself, a behemoth with a 100-ton payload capacity that dwarfs competitors' capabilities. Lueders emphasized its potential to transport sufficient cargo to construct permanent structures on the moon, underscoring the transformative nature of this vehicle. The profound impact of Starship, as articulated by Lueders, extends beyond the technical realm. It enables sustained operations and research on the moon's south pole, opening vistas for ongoing scientific exploration and discovery. Starbase, in its current evolution, is a hotbed of construction activity, a testament to the dynamic growth trajectory charted by SpaceX. The addition of a second orbital launch pad and a million-square-foot factory, coupled with plans for additional employee housing and office space, signifies a commitment to scaling operations and meeting the demands of a burgeoning space industry. The imperative for a second launch pad is intricately linked to SpaceX's ambitious goal of achieving a faster launch cadence, underlining the strategic considerations that govern operational planning. A noteworthy revelation in Lueders' discourse was the relocation of much of the engine testing to SpaceX's Massey test site, situated on a former gun range west of Starbase. This strategic move is not merely a logistical adjustment. It serves a crucial purpose in minimizing disruptions to beach operations. The emphasis on keeping testing operations away from the beach resonates with a commitment to environmental and operational considerations, a nuanced approach that recognizes the need for balance in conducting complex testing activities. Lueders, in a candid reflection on her personal experience, shared that her residence, situated merely 2 miles away from the launch site, remained unscathed despite the intense vibrations from launches. This revelation offered a glimpse into the meticulous measures undertaken by SpaceX to ensure that sound and vibration levels are meticulously monitored and maintained within limits agreed upon by the FAA for each launch. The emphasis on these metrics, coupled with the acknowledgement of the uniqueness and excitement of witnessing rocket launches from one's backyard, conveyed a sense of responsibility and engagement with the local community. As the narrative unfolded, Lueders peeled back the layers of complexity inherent in conducting rocket launches. Rockets, she noted, are inherently loud, yet they ascend into the air with remarkable speed. The acknowledgement of the auditory and visual impact of rocket launches on local residents, framed within the broader context of understanding and mitigating these effects, serves as a testament to SpaceX's commitment to harmonizing technological progress with community well-being. The acknowledgement that the Florida community is accustomed to the sonic rumbles generated by rocket launches underscored a sense of shared understanding and partnership between SpaceX and the local populace. In a poignant reflection, Lueders encourage the community to cherish the opportunity of witnessing rocket launches from their backyards, expressing a sentiment that resonates with her own enduring appreciation for the awe-inspiring spectacle. Her reminder not to let the experience grow old serves as a testament to the transformative nature of space exploration, transcending the technical and scientific realms to evoke a sense of wonder and admiration for the celestial endeavors unfolding in our midst. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.